Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to review a Word document with track changes in the Word Processor component, also known as the Document Editor. I'll show you how to enable the Track Changes feature, accept or reject changes, filter changes by user, and use revision-only protection. First, I open my existing application, where I've installed the Syncfusion EJ2 React Document Editor package. I have also configured the necessary modules to render the component. I have also enabled the toolbar. You can refer to my React Word Processor Getting Started video to learn how to render the component. I've included a link to it in the card above and the description below. Let me run the application and show you the initial output. See, Document Editor is rendered with toolbar. By toggling this Track Changes option, you can keep track of the changes made in the document. To explain this feature, I will open a Word document with tracked changes. Click this Open option, then select a Word document with tracked changes. After the document opens, you can notice the Review pane is shown in the Document Editor. I can review the document and make changes. When a new word or sentence is added, it will be underlined. A deleted character or word is marked with a strike through. Here, the list of changes will be shown along with the users who made them. I can perform several actions here. Filter changes by user. To view only the deletions, select the deleted option from this dropdown. Using these two options, I can navigate to the next tracked change or previous track change. Before exploring other options, I hide the Properties pane. Here, you can accept or reject a specific change for the selected users. I accept this change. Using these options, you can accept or reject all changes for the user Trace Watkins. Now, I click Accept All Changes. To accept all the changes by different users, select the option All in the View and User dropdowns and click Accept All Changes. See, all the revisions are accepted. I will explain how to perform all these actions programmatically. You can enable or disable this feature by adding the Enable Track Changes property. By default, the Track Changes feature is enabled. You can disable it by setting its value to false. But to demonstrate all the options in this feature, I'll set its value to true right now. Since I'm not focusing on the Properties pane, so I'll disable it. I add the Show Properties pane property and set its value to false. Checking now, the Properties pane is hidden. Before exploring other options programmatically, I need to get the Document Editor instance first to access its built-in methods. So, I declare a variable editor object of the type Document Editor component. Next, I add the ref property and initialize the editor object. Now, I will show you how to accept or reject changes programmatically using an external button click. I add the button element to accept all the track changes and add the button content, accept all. Then, I add the onClick event and assign the callback method, onButtonClick. I define this method here. Inside this method, I get all the revisions using editorObject.DocumentEditor.Revisions and call the accept_all method. Add the inline style margin bottom 10 pixels to the button. Here, I have already opened a Word document with tracked changes. When I click the Accept All button, the changes are accepted. To reject all changes, just replace this method with Reject All. Change the button caption to Reject All. See, I click this button and reject all the changes. Next, I will show you how to accept and reject specific revisions. In the onButtonClick method, I replace the rejectAll method with the get method, and need to pass the revision index here. I pass the value 0 to accept the first revision. Then call the accept method. And change the button caption to accept. Notice the first revision here. Page number added in the footer. When I click this button, the first revision is accepted. Now, to reject the specific revision, I pass the revision ID 1 to reject the second revision and call the reject method. I also change the caption to reject. Look here, when this button is clicked, the second revision is rejected. Next, I will show you how to navigate between the revisions. Here, I add another button to navigate to the next revision from current one. I set its content to next. I add the onClick button and assign the callback method next revision. I define this method here. Using the document editor instance, I call the method documentEditor.selection.navigateNextRevision. Now I add the inline style margin bottom to 10 pixels and margin left to 5 pixels. To navigate to the previous revision, I add another button. I set the content to previous. I change the onClick callback method name, previous revision. I define this method here. Using the document editor instance, I call the method navigate previous revision. Check now, when I click this button, the selection moves to the next revision. And clicking this button navigates to the previous revision. In some cases, I want people to make changes in the document, but don't want them to be able to accept or reject the track changes. Only the author is allowed to do that. To implement this, I'll make use of the revision-only protection feature. I include another button to protect the document. I set the content to revision only. I change the onClick callback method name to protection. I define this method here. Using the document editor instance, I call the method documentEditor.editor.enforceProtection. Here, I need to provide two arguments, credentials and protection type. Here, I pass the credentials 123 and choose type revision only. To stop protection, copy-paste this button code. Here, I change the button caption to stop protection. And the onClick method name to remove protection. I define this method here. Inside this method, I use the editor instance and call the editor.stopProtection method. Here, I pass the credentials 123. Checking now, when I click this button, you cannot accept or reject any changes. And I click this button to allow you to accept or reject changes. In this video, I showed you how to review a Word document with track changes and the basic options for tracking. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.